News 8's political analyst Dr. Terry Madonna joins us now with a look at how tonight's vote could impact the political landscape across the rest of the country.
Well, Dr. Madonna, Scott Brown says flat out he will not vote for health care reform.
That's correct, and he's called for the Senate to start over, literally start over. Ditch what's happened, begin the process anew. One of the interesting things, Janelle, was not only did he make the case against the current administration's policy directions, but you know what he did? He talked about backroom deals. He talked about the trades. I think that resonated with the voters just as much as the policy direction that we currently see in Washington.
Which brings me to that question. How much of this is a commentary to President Obama and the Democratic Congress?
Well, personally, President Obama remains very popular in Massachusetts. I mean, he's got about a 55% favorable rating, Ron. The problem is that the health care debate in and of itself and the failure to turn the corner on the recession, no matter what one says about the policies that the government has been pursuing, we're still in a recession. The voters still don't like the direction of the country. But this was, in effect, a referendum on the president, health care, and the Democratic Congress. I don't think you can make any other argument.
So the U.S. Senate will no longer be filibuster-proof for the
Correct.
Democrats, but that does not mean they cannot get legislation through.
Oh, of course. I mean, there are a variety of ways just on health care they could do it. You know, do reconciliation. That's 51 vote majority by, you know, doing a special process. They could take, as we point out, the Senate bill and pass it in the House just as it is.
Sure.
Literally change nothing. They may be reluctant to do that given this tsunami that we've just seen. This is huge. I mean, there's virtually no parallel in modern history that puts this into that same perspective.
That'll have to be the last word. Dr. Madonna, as always, thanks for joining us
tonight.
Thanks,
Ron.